Hi, this is Shawn from 3M. Thanks for tuning in. In this video, I'd like to address some of the questions that we receive at 3M on a daily basis regarding the proper use of weld-through coatings. So let's get started. Okay, the first thing I'd like to address is the science behind a weld-through coating. And you'll notice I didn't call it a weld-through primer because it actually is not a primer. A primer is used to promote adhesion for subsequent coatings. And because this can contains mostly zinc powder with just a few solvents to make it sprayable, it is not a good primer that's going to promote adhesion. As a matter of fact, things do not stick well to this product. It's not designed for that. It's designed to go in between the flanges to protect our welds from corrosion. So the reason they use zinc in this product is because zinc provides what we call sacrificial corrosion. Sacrificial corrosion means that once the zinc is applied, because it's got a higher electrical charge than the surface it's being applied to, it'll actually transfer electrons to that steel surface, which will mitigate corrosion. So the zinc in the product is specifically designed for that sacrificial corrosion. The name weld-through primer really is a misnomer. It's not really a primer, which we've discussed, but also we should not actually weld through or right over the top of weld-through primer. It's considered a weld contaminant. And actually, if you look at a lot of the OEM statements, they will actually specify to clean it from the weld zone before welding. We only want to be welding on clean, bare metal. So one of the first things we need to do after it's applied is to remove it from the immediate weld zone, and I'm going to show a demonstration on one of the best ways and easiest ways to do that. But in the meantime, again, consult the OEMs for their specific information on the use of a weld-through coating, and they may specify the type of coating and how that coating is used, or even recommend that it not be used in certain cases. But the important thing to remember is we must clean it out of the weld zone and not weld over the top of it. So I have a small prop here, and I want to walk through step by step how to apply weld-through coating properly and prepare for welding. So I've previously abraded these surfaces here where it's going to be applied, and there's a number of ways we can do that. We could use a file belt sander with a Scotch-Brite belt or an 80 grit abrasive. We could also use a roll-off grinder with an 80 grit abrasive or a clean and strip wheel or a number of different products. Again, follow the instructions for the application of the product on the can. So I'm gonna now mask this off, get my safety equipment on, and we'll walk through those steps. So I've applied my first coat. This product requires 2 light coats and 5 to 10 minutes of flash time in between. And then it's a good idea to wait until it's dry to the touch before we start welding. So let's continue to walk through this process step by step. Okay, so I've applied a second coat. Now, don't skip that second coat. It's very important that we get adequate film thickness coverage on those surfaces to get that good corrosion protection to surround those welds. The next thing I want to mention is that you noticed I did mask this off. And the reason I masked this off is because this product does not have binders like a regular primer. So nothing is going to stick well to it, and it does not stick well to other surfaces. So if we get any overspray on the vehicle parts, it needs to be cleaned off. So again, a simple way to avoid that is just to mask it off to begin with. However, if we do, This wipes off very easily with typical body shop cleaners. So let's continue on, and I'll now show you how to remove that coating from the weld area so we don't get contaminated welds. Now that I've applied my Weld-Through primer, both coats, and allowed it to flash, and it's actually dry to the touch, we can mate these parts together. Now, what I want to show you is a very simple way to clean the primer from the immediate weld zone. Remember, it's a weld contaminant. We want to clear it out of there and only weld to clean bare metal. So in this case, I've got plug weld holes that are previously punched. So as a technician, the best thing you can do is pre-punch your holes before you test fit the panel. For example, you're applying a quarter panel, you want to punch your holes first before you test fit and line up all your gaps. So once those holes are punched and we mate these surfaces together, and I'm going to clamp these in place, so again, if we're working on a vehicle, I'm going to apply my clamps, line up all my gaps, and once I'm to that point, now I can see the Weld-Through primer exposed in the center of those plug weld holes. So if I try to weld over the top of that, we're going to get a very poor weld that's porous, and many OEMs, again, call out that it should be cleaned from the immediate weld zone. So a simple solution is, once the panel's clamped on, take a marker and mark where all those plug weld holes are. And this just takes a couple minutes, but it's going to make your life much easier when you're welding to clean bare metal than trying to weld over the top of a Weld-Through primer. Once I have these all marked, I can remove my clamps. Then when I remove the top panel, I can see where I need to remove the coatings. So I'm going to get on my safety equipment and grind off these areas where I want the primer removed. So as you can see now, I've simply removed the primer just from these specific weld spots, which isn't going to sacrifice corrosion protection at all, but it will definitely make it much easier to weld when you're welding on clean steel versus attempting to weld through a coating. So once I mate these back together and clamp them in place, I can see nice, clean, bare steel in these areas, and it's going to make for a much more successful repair. So one last thing before I go, I just wanted to mention, we all know that automotive technologies and OEM recommendations are changing quickly. It's really difficult to stay up to date with the latest procedures. If you are looking for more advanced instruction on collision repair techniques, please check us out at 3M Collision Repair Academy. We've launched an online learning program with tons of courses that you can get and take at your own pace, along with receiving our credits along the way. If you're new to collision repair or you've been around the block a little like me, we still think you can learn a few things. Our goal is to really give you those tools that you need to succeed. We'll put a link in the description below, so please check that out. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching. Hope you like this video. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the little bell icon so you know when videos are posted. If you have any questions, please leave a comment or give us a thumbs up, and we'll see you next time.